will be talking to the Daragang Magayon herself, Jash Dimaculangan from Binibining Pilipinas. Hi Jash, happy Valentine's.
Yeah, happy Valentine's. Thank you for having me. Hello, good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Now, Jash, again, I am doing this because I want to introduce you gals to the rest of the Filipino pageant-loving fans. Kasi malapit na rin ang Binibining Pilipinas. After nito, ilang tumbling na rin. So, might as well reintroduce you to the fans. So, Jash, please give us an idea because I read a little bit about your bio. It only talked about your pageant history. Pero wala ka rin masyadong alam sa'yo. So, please, the floor is yours. Reintroduce yourself to everyone.
Okay, hi everyone. My name is Jash Dimaculangan. You're Binibini 27, representing Albay. I'm 25 years old and I have a bachelor's degree in commerce and business administration, major in marketing management from University of Santo Tomas, Manila. And right now, during quarantine, I've been helping my sister's business in the atelier, Cheryl Vicente. Also, quick hint, she's my designer for my evening gown. And ayun, my advocacy is anti-bullying. And ayun lang naman, very short lang.
Ayun, so yun pala si Jash. So right now, Jash, you're busy. Kasi alam naman natin na a lot of things stop during the height of the global pandemic. Pero alam ko rin na because I also work in bridal, I also work in fashion, so alam ko rin yung medyo yung impact nun sa ganung industriya. Kamusta naman yung trabaho mo dun sa industry na yun, knowing na sister mo rin?
Yes, actually for the first few months, we were okay kasi may mga backlogs na clients. Pero a few months in the quarantine, we really felt the hit. Talagang parang, syempre walang events, no one's going out. So we tried to parang focus more on the PPEs, masks, although it brought a little bit of income. Pero we just decided to take a quick pause for now. So, ayun, hopefully matapos na yung pandemic para yung event, actually hindi lang naman yung fashion industry, yung mga events, also the pageants in Bicol, nag-stop din talaga. So, ang dami rin talagang naapektuhan.
Oo, pero kamusta naman yung ikaw mismo? Kasi syempre, before nangyari lahat to, you were in the middle of preparing for Binibining Pilipinas. Mukhang maayos yung preparation mo kasi at around that time na nakikita namin, tuloy-tuloy naman yung updates mo. So, kumbaga kung yung timeline mo, at least sa side namin ng mga admins, sa side namin ng mga nakikinood, mukhang nasusunod naman. How did you adjust knowing na the pageant preparation had to take a step back?
A very nice question. Actually, ang in-inform ng sa amin is 2-week COVID break during the BDP. Yun lang yung alam namin, 2 weeks and then we'll be back. And then hanggang sa nag-quarantine na, we had to really take a few months off. Pero I took it as a good thing kasi personally, alam ko na there are some improvements that I could do within myself. Parang now na 2021 na, I look back on my pictures, I look back on my performance, parang hindi pa ako ganun kahinog. And now na, ano, parang few months na, I read some books, talagang I built myself physically, emotionally, and spiritually. Mas prepared ako ngayon. So, hindi ko siya iniisip na, shucks, tumanda na ako. Kasi yun din yung talagang ano, impact eh, yung age namin. Parang lahat kami nag-birthday na. So, parang ako, okay, sige, parang I'll take this as a challenge para pagbalik ko, brand new Jash na yung ibigay ko sa pageant pack.
So, this whole time, you've been also doing your part in preparation. Actually, tama naman din talaga yun. Kasi yung mga ibang preparations like the pasarela, even styling, medyo nahirapan na yung gumalaw yung mga girls niyan eh. But at least on your own, hinawakan mo ano yung mga pwede mo pang gawin, like studying on your own and trying to get familiar maybe with the social issues. So, kamusta naman tayo dun sa aspetong yun ng training? Medyo nakapag, nabalansin mo na ba on how to work or continue your Binibining training knowing na ang dami pa rin limitations up to now?
Yes, the first few months yun nga, I've been studying on my own, pero the past few weeks, kaya training have started already. So, we're focusing more on our Q&A, getting familiar with social issues because a year ago, totally different yung current events. Like, iba talaga. And now, parang ang dami ng mga bagong ganap, especially with the COVID and stuff. So, I'm very thankful na KF is still taking a step on improving us. Like, hindi din talaga muna kami pinabayaan. And they know na parang ito napapalapit na kailangan game mode na ulit kami mga girls.
Curious ako about beauty pageant training. Kasi when I talk about pageant training, I talk about it from an observer's point of view. Iba kasi syempre kapag ikaw yung nandun. Knowing na limited na lang din yung crowns ng Binibining Pilipinas, because most likely nung naisip mo na sumali sa Binibining Pilipinas, mas maraming corona ang available sa'yo. But this time around, paano ang attacking you, Jash? Do you stick with the curriculum pagdating sa training, o medyo nalilihis ngayon because you have to take into consideration ano ang hinahanap ng mga natitirang corona sa Binibini?
Oh my gosh, I love your question. Lahat kami, may isa kami training for that. But depende sa girl ano yung gusto mong atake. Pero when it comes to kaya training, it's more on personality development, communication skills, public speaking. Personally, I think parang it's one of my favorites. I love talking. So I really take it to heart tuwing may mga Zoom training kami and all. Also, yung about dun sa atake, I'm not really specific with that, although I have my own strategy. But hindi ako yung dapat tinutulog ko, dapat fierce ako, dapat, kasi I want to cater to every pageant fans. I want to show them that I'm very versatile. You can put me sa pang-model, you can put me sa pang-sweet. Kasi pag phoenix mo yung sarili mo sa isang crown, and my girl na mas perfect para doon, you fall behind. Either you're runner-up or you're top 15. Pero kung pasok ka doon, ako ito yung personal, ano rin natin ko. Pero kung pasok ka doon sa each crown, mas malaki yung chances mo. Kasi masakit sa puso kapag ka-phoenix mo yung sarili mo sa isa, pero winner ka pa rin naman eh. It's just that you didn't get the title that you wanted. Pero parang, mas maliit yung chance mo maging masaya, di ba?
Okay yung mindset na yan din. Kasi minsan may nakausap din ako, Binibini, winner, napag-uusapan namin yan, no, when it comes to international pageants, meron talagang peg. Pero madugo ang labanan sa Binibining Pilipinas kasi walang peg. So, kailangan lahat yun ma-peg mo. Kailangan ma-check mo lahat ng mga kinakailangan nila. So, Binibining Pilipinas is a very visual affair. So, it comes with your styling, with your makeup, your wardrobe and everything. Kamusta tayo dun sa aspetong yun? Sa preparation mo leading to the finals, hopefully this April.
Yes. Well, actually ngayon mas alam ko na yung the look na mas bagay sa akin. Kasi nung una parang medyo nangangapa pa ako, nag-experiment. Di ba may mga ganong
kumibig? Oo naman.
Or kitanista. Pero ngayon, mas confident na ako sa look ko, mas confident na ako sa styling ko, sa team ko. Like, I found a team that really works for me. And actually, I went home to Albay last week. We did a couple of shots and photoshoots. And I'm very happy with the output. Kasi I can finally say na this is the look that I want. This is the parang image na gusto kong ilabas sa tao.
Yun yung gusto ko sana ma-share mo lalo. Kasi of course, Jash, you are now a public figure and everybody has access to you. In fact, even ako, if you remember, nagpapadala ako sa'yo. Hindi ng pegs eh. Sometimes we do this to the girls. Depende na sa level of comfortability ko na makipag-chika-chika sa kanila. But I particularly remember, nag-post ako ng litrato mo, tapos sabi ko, lock in this look. Kasi sometimes yung styling mo doon, mahilig ka sa red lipstick, mahilig ka dun sa parang pixie in the hair. So, when you change it up, tapos bagay sa'yo, parang, uy, okay to ah. Gano'y yung feeling mo noon na ngayon sinasabi mo sa akin na alam mo na kung ano yung atake mo, alam mo na yung look mo. Ano yung naramdaman mo when you figured out na, uy, ito yung bagay sa akin. Mukhang ano yung gusto kong i-explore.
Well, of course, I'm a lot more confident now. Kasi when I entered VT, I didn't know what to expect. Parang I was a baby, and parang being with these other girls, I learned from them. And being in the public eye, as you said, parang ang daming opinions na papasok sa'yo. Some may think na it's a very negative thing, na parang lagi kang sinasabihan na ito dapat. Pero me, I always take it positively. Kasi I know na nakikita nila yun, sila yung nakakita eh. So dapat you always take into consideration their opinion. So ayun lang, I think yung attitude ko din na mas open ako sa opinion ng ibang tao, and I don't take anything personally. Nagkaroon siya ng good impact sa transformation ko.
So bagay na, it's how you look at it. Sometimes kasi when you're too into what other people are saying, sometimes dumadating doon na parang very intrusive sila, na mas marami pa silang alam. But if you know, they're like you, at least on the positive note, teka nga, baka nga may alam sila, try natin to. Kamusta naman ang team? Receptive naman sila dun sa ganun klaseng changes o dun sa opinions ng iba na parang feeling mo, uy, wait, mag-work sa akin.
Yes, actually before kasi I came from people, di ba? We have our own look there. Yung look dun talagang pageant, boom, glam.
Okay.
We call pageants. But then I decided on my own. Also when I worked with Patrick Henry in my last shoot, parang he opened up my eye na eto, bagay sa'yo tong look na to.
Thanks,
kalma
sir.
Na.
Thanks, Sir Patrick.
Diba? Parang artista lang ang peg. Parang dun ko na-explore yung side there. Nakita ko yung mga pictures ko na parang, oh, kaya ko naman pala ng hindi laban na laban na makeup eh. Diba? So, okay din na yung you to work with other people who has a different perception sa looks. Ganon, na you can open up your eyes sa kung anong bagay sa'yo. So, I think it really helped me. And I shared it with my team. And yeah, super happy din naman sila and I'm happy na they got along.
So, you talked about Sir Patrick Henry, you talked about Bicol. Of course, we cannot go without talking about the other Daragang Magayon, which is Catriona Gray. Ano yung naging inspiration ni Kat sa'yo, knowing that it, you know, from the same area, you know, representing the same province, trying to put the province on the map, not just, you know, in pageantry, but, you know, globally as well. Anong meron sa Bicol ngayon? Anong gusto nating i-highlight sa Bicol ngayon, apart from the gata and the volcano and the chili? Ano pa ang pwede nating malaman tungkol sa Bicol ngayon na hindi namin alam usually?
Well, everyone knows naman na yung mga delicacy, pinangat, lumayon. Pero I want to show and I want to highlight the talent of the Bicolanos. Lately, yung I went home to Bicol, I made it a point na all of the clothes that I'll be wearing are Bicol made. All of my team, my makeup artist to the photographer are Bicolanos kasi I want to show the talent sa national stage kasi everyone are waiting for our pictures and it's really an honor for me to, you know, help out. And kahit yung mga batang photographer na nagsastart pa lang, talaga may potential sila. I asked my friends there to look for, you know, young talents who would want to collaborate with me. And ayun, I'm so excited. Also, yung ask mo about Catriona, she really inspired me to highlight Albay. Before, when I first joined, parang feeling kasi nila when you join, it's just about you. Like, yung, I don't want to say, pero yung ibang girls, like, it's about them, about their pictures. Pero one friend told me, Raph, he's a pageant enthusiast as well. Parang nag-message lang siya as suggestion na parang all the things that you do, you should do it for your province. Parang yun, nagdatak sa isip ko yun na dapat lahat ng ginagawa ko, lahat ng steps ko, I represent my province kasi that's my identity from now on joining Binibini. Parang merong meaning kung ba't kami binigyan ng sash. Kasi before, wala namang sash eh, diba? Like, it's just numbers, I'm Binibini 27, pero now yes. I'm Binibini Albay. And yun, parang I just really want to represent my province very well.
Nice. I like this. I like the idea because no one really talks about the fact that before it was just numbers and now it's actually a sash with your province on it. So it wouldn't make sense if you go out there at pang pageant na laban ka lang without also incorporating kung ano yung meron sa hometown mo. And I would definitely understand because with Kat naman kasi, it was like for the bigger picture. It was trying to represent, you know, other ethnicities and other aspects of Filipino culture. Pero ikaw is Albay. So ngayon talagang stand-alone ka. Pwede mong hubutin yung talent pool sa paligid mo. And I'm glad that you mentioned this kasi now, whenever I would make hubot your photos, iisipin ko, this is a team from Bicol. So, di ba? Ang ganda rin naman na nadadala sila ngayon dito. So, bullying is something that you have been advocating. Bullying is also something that I'm familiar with. I am either a victim of bullying or someone who opens up the doors for bullying. So, me as a person, I'm very polarizing. But I want you, Jash, to give everyone like your peace of mind regarding online bullying because apparently it's just so easy to do that at madali ka rin mabasag doon. Anong tips mo sa kanila? How you can do it if you're on both sides of the spectrum?
Yeah. I think it's very common nowadays, especially na everything is just online. We're all at our own homes, pero at the same time, we're all connected through internet. And it's so easy to just type behind a fake name, a fake email address, and then say whatever you want to that person. Pero ngayon kasi, wala tayong laws that protects us from that. Like, wala pa tayong technology here in the Philippines na we could really bring those people to justice, most especially those who, yung mga nagpapakalat ng fake news, libels, and all. But what I can say is to the victims na just be strong and alam mo yung take, yung tulad sinabi ko, kapag may sabi sa'yo na negative, piliin mo lang, i-filter mo lang yung papasok sa isip mo. Kasi others' opinions will always be there, but it's up to you how you would handle it. Like, even me personally, parang sa comments when someone posts a picture of me, and may mga magko-comment talaga na parang, uy, grabe to ah. Pero, you know what? The least you can do is just ignore it. Kasi the more you respond, the more that you give them the power. And mas masarap sa feeling nila yun na nanonotice mo sila. So, ayun. And I think, tita, ikaw din, familiar ka rin. Like, sa page mo, medyo, minsan may nagkakain kita yun sa comment section. Ako, nakikibasa lang ako.
Nakikibasa, nakikichichi. Tama nga naman. Actually, pag ako naman, dahil bullying na rin naman to, because like I said, I am either of a victim because it's so easy to pick on me. I am very public now and yeah, may mga aspects na, you know, you can pick on, but at the same time, ako rin naman yung biniblame na nag-uumpisa ng bullying kasi meron kami platform, and if I'm vocal there, that's also considered bullying on some end. So, ano ngayon ang mga programs mo in mind? Meron ka bang mga causes, mga advocacies moving forward para masulong tong anti-bullying campaign
mo? Well, firstly, kasi when I started, I wanted to focus more on schools. Kasi from my experience, I was bullied in high school and it was a physical bullying. So now na nag-deviate na tayo sa nag-pandemic na and online classes, para I'm thinking of a new way na we can mediate yung bullying online. Kasi yung focus ko talaga is physical bullying. Pero now, I think we have to adjust as well para nakakapag-adjust tayo sa happening sa life and sa current events. But that's a very good point nga about online bullying. Na ito nga rin talaga yung bagong, like, mas concentrated dito yung mga mean girls and bullies.
Okay, so malapit na ang Binibining Pilipinas. Kung tutuusin mo, actually, kung wala naman talaga tayong problema na naman, push na siguro yan sa April. Jash, please let them know, gano'n ka na ba ka-ready? Ano bang mga aabangan namin sa'yo? And please also invite them to your social media platforms kasi alam ko may date ka pa and I wouldn't want to keep you longer.
Guys, thank you so much sa lahat ng patuloy na sumusuporta sa akin. It really means a lot, lalo na sa mga kababayan ko sa Bicol, sa Capalonga, Camarines Norte, sa Albay, na patuloy na sumusuporta sa akin. You can follow me on my personal Instagram, Jash Dimaculangan. We have official Facebook page, Jash Dimaculangan. And ayun, thank you so much, Tita Lavinia, for having me. It's such an honor. Happy Valentine's!